Hey, welcome to another Vampire video, and I'm sorry for my voice, I'm a bit snivelly today, but we're going to do something different. We're going to read manga, and what we're going to do in the manga is actually find cars and identify them. And that may sound very boring, but for me it's actually kind of a sport. The book I'm going to read today is, well, I'm not going to read it entirely, but only partially. It's The Walking Man by Jiro Taniguchi. And I actually bought this book after browsing through it and then finding a couple of images that took my interest. So this book itself is by a manga author from the 70s, 80s and 90s mostly. And what he did was capture the time in the 80s really well in this book. So what he did was actually create small stories in the 80s about a man that was just walking in his neighborhood. He just moved somewhere, and that was quite interesting because it captures the time of the early 80s, mid 80s really well, and some of the stories later in the book are from the early 90s. But it's a time capsule. And he published these stories like one a year or something. So it's really interesting to read through it. I'm going to browse a bit now through the pages so you can get like an idea of what it looks like. Alright, so on page 15 we have the first car we can identify here, and it looked so familiar to me, I couldn't even find which one it was. But actually, this is a Toyota Sprinter E80. It's the hatchback. And what really gives it away are the wheels and the back window. Then you can also see Honda Acty next to the other dog. And you can see from the other side coming a Honda Cup or a Super Cup moped. It's not really clear which one it is. On the page after that, we can see a Mitsubishi Colt 1000 truck. It's weird that they called it a Colt 1000. And then at the bottom, probably a Mazda Familia 323. Not entirely sure. I think it's the first 323 series. So that must be, I think, the Familia 3rd or 4th generation. And what I really like about this book is the level of detail that things have been drawn in, and most of these probably are originating from pictures, and it's more of a shame in the West to do picture tracing and then publishing that as a comic or something, but in Japan it's actually used for backgrounds to make it more accurate. So it's a bit of a different thing. All right, on page 24 we have there's a bus coming and there's an unknown car. I really had some difficulty identifying this. I thought it might actually be a Nissan Laurel C31. Couldn't make much out of it. I tried to enlarge it after scanning it. Couldn't make it out at all. But the bus, I could find that one. That's a Mitsubishi Fuso Aero Midi bus. On page 25, the opposite page, we can see a stoplight or traffic light, depending on how you would call it. In Dutch, we call it a stoplight. At the second panel, you can see a Suzuki Carry. And then in front of that, we can see something that resembles an A86. And presumably it's a Sprinter A86. What gives it away are the rear tail lights. It's slightly different than from the 11. It's at least a three door, that's for sure. On the third panel, you can see a Suzuki Carry flatbed truck. And then coming from the other side, we have a Toyota Hiace H11, one of the first Hiaces. We have a Nissan Gloria Hardtop Y30 on the other side of the road as well. Then one panel underneath that's a Metro, obviously. And then at the bottom panel we have, and that took me quite a while, a Toyota Chaser GX71. we have a Honda Super Cup moped coming the same way, and then on the opposite lane you have a Subaru Rex third generation, and then the fourth car over there, or the third car actually, it's unknown for me. I wasn't able to identify that one. All right, then we have an interesting panel, because this is more interesting for me. That's on the top panel we have either a Carina A60 or we have a Corona T140 here. I wasn't entirely sure which one it was. Looking at the fender shape, I would say it's the Corona. However, the way the front bumper wraps around, it's actually more accurate for a Carina, so I'm not entirely sure. Then we have a Mercedes, presumably 190. And then we can skip a couple of pages here. All right, a new chapter called Rain, and what we have here is on the left in the topmost panel, a Mazda Bongo van. It's the third generation of this van. In the back we can see a Toyota Crown. It's the S120 hardtop. Which one it actually is, like a Royal Saloon or something, I cannot make that out. Then we have another Mitsubishi Fuso Aero Midibus here again, and then that car in the front, that's a difficult one to identify, and I guess it actually is a Toyota Sprinter AE100. So given that this is a Toyota Sprinter AE100, this must be somewhere early 90s. Then the car we see in the front side of the panel, I cannot make it out. It's presumably a taxi, so then it would be the Corona T140 taxi. The lower panel on the left, we can see immediately a Skyline, and that's this was actually the panel that sold me the book. I immediately spotted those taillights and I was like, whoa, that's a Skyline. So it's a Skyline R30. It doesn't have a rear wiper, which is a bit odd, because most of these Skylines actually got rear wipers. Was a really nice 80s thing. On the opposite of the road we have a Starlet EP70 or EP71, not entirely sure which one it is, and then the others are unclear to me which ones they are. Of course the bus is another Mitsubishi Fuso Aero Midibus. Skipping the pages after that, because that's just the same bus. Some plane in the sky, which I cannot tell what it is. I'm going to skip these because it's a naked man, so probably otherwise YouTube will scold me. On page 53 we end up with a Toyota Light Ace M10, first generation Light Ace, at least I think it is. It's difficult to identify because it's only one panel. On the other panel it's probably the same van, but I cannot be sure about that. Alright, and then we end up at the After the Storm story, and After the Storm story was a bit of a oddball here. It took me a very long time to figure this one out, because on page 57 we have a Nissan Gloria 430, and you can immediately spot that it's spot on. If you compare it to the photos that I've included here, it is definitely a Gloria 430. However, if you turn the page to page 58, he crawls underneath the tree, and when he gets underneath the tree, apparently he gets into some sort of, I don't know, other dimension, because the front of the car all of a sudden is a Toyota Crown Royal Saloon MS120, and that's a bit odd. How does a car end up with that? So either it's a Kaido Racer where they swap front ends or swap parts, which I don't think it is. He apparently lives in a bit of a posh neighborhood, so this is probably an error by the comic artist, or a cock-up, or however you would call it. He works probably with photographs, and then he didn't really care what the car looked like from the front, or he wanted to confuse us deliberately. The finalizing the story that ends up at page 62, and that's also where I'm going to end this manga reading today. That's it. I hope you enjoyed identifying these cars as much as I did, actually. If you like this new format or this new type of video, just let me know in the comments below. I would really be interested in knowing how many of you would like to see me read more manga. Maybe you can give some hints of manga that I should read. Or maybe I should be reading other comics, and you can tell me which comics I should read and then identify those cars as well. Because it's kind of a hobby of mine, just looking at the backgrounds of these comics and then identifying what cars are in there. One of those comics is actually Initial D, where the author of Initial D is using a lot of photographs to use as backgrounds, and then he traces them, and it's really interesting to see how often he actually reuses the same photograph. But that's maybe for another episode, I don't know. I've been rambling way too long for now. That's it. Thank you for watching, and hope to see you next time.